Let's go see if we can find Denny Long. Here we are at WCCO's Hallway of Fame. All of our announcers here, including Sid Hartman. Hi, Sid.
Hi, girl.
That's Mike Max, Dark Star, Charlie Boone, and here's Denny Long, our subject.
Co-host with Sid Hartman of the Sports Huddle. It starts in just a couple of minutes. I'm sorry, Dave. Could you talk a little bit about Denny Long?
Denny who? I got one.
Okay, Denny Long. Well, you know, I can't think of anything good about Denny Long. Wait a minute, cut. Obviously, I'm kidding. Denny Long is a long-standing personality here at WCCO Radio. And one thing about Denny, I worked with him for more than 30 years. He is one of truly most genuine, nicest guys that you can ever work with. I consider him a friend in addition to a workmate here at WCCO Radio. And he's so comfortable to work with on the air as well as off the air. And that's a big part of his success, I think, here. He's very genuine. He comes across on the air as a friend that you can talk to about anything, and that's the kind of guy he is. I think he makes guests very comfortable when they're with him on the air. I know when I come in and do newscasts on his show, and he'll talk to me on the air a little bit afterwards, I'm always comfortable with that. I never worry about him throwing a curve at me or making me look bad, because that can happen with some people on the air. He doesn't let ego, he doesn't have that big ego that can get in the way of being a real person. So that's a big part of his success, I would say. All right, I'm here with WCCO Radio's Denny Long, who is a legend at the station in his own mind. And
I didn't pass away yet.
No, this isn't one of those. Right. We're talking a little bit about brokered shows, what we call them, or shows that are sponsored, and then the actual sponsor physically comes in and you take calls on, say, home improvement or gardening or whatever, and Denny is our king of those shows. What are some of the shows that...
Well, some people might think of them as infomercials, but that you can always tell an infomercial like a mile away, because I'm here with Dr. So-and-so. It's the same show every week.
Yeah.
That's different. I like to call them help shows. The station calls them, like you said, brokerage shows. The client pays for an hour's worth of time, and usually it's the client who is the expert. Sometimes we have an expert, and it's sponsored by a client, like our computer show, for example.
Where Bruce Helmer,
the financial show, he is the client, and he is also the president of the company.
Okay.
And he is also a financial planner, so he's the expert all the way around.
So then what is your role with that?
I'm kind of like, I don't know if I should call it the anchor. Some people like to say it's a co-host, and just by inference, because my presence there, I guess I could be a co-host. But Dan, you saw me. I'm a guy that you got to look at the log, you got to watch the clock, you take the phone calls. You don't take them, but you read them off the screen.
Sure.
And catch them up. So it's like a facilitator, I guess you could call it.
Okay, so you kind of pilot the ship.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I fly it on track. Yeah.
Keep it on track,
yeah. Yeah, exactly.
That would be a train, yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway.
You're your teacher, right?
thank you. You've been at WCCO since, and what was your first... duty here?
Moses, I think.
Moses?
Moses came to me and said, you're on weekends. I am almost finishing 39 years.
39 years?
Yes, 38 plus.
Wow.
Yeah, I was a child prodigy.
Who'd have thought?
I was 10 when I got here.
Yeah, that would have been my life.
But it's been a heck of a good ride. It really has.
Does it seem like that long?
Not really, no. Not really. I mean, if you're doing what you like to do, it flies by.
Okay. And when you first started, you were doing weekends then?
Well, actually, I was brought here to not only to be music director for WCCO AM, but also WCCO FM, which, as you know, is WLightning, WLTE.
Okay.
So in 71, when I got here, I was on CCO FM from 2 to 6 p.m., we are broadcasting from the Fauché Tower, 2,800 watts. That was at that time. And they kept asking me, excuse me, the management, say, I know you're working Monday through Friday, but we need some help on the weekends on CCO Radio. Would you mind filling in? So many times I'd be working 7 days a week, five in the FM, two on the weekend, Saturday, Sunday on CCO Radio. Then we played music, as you know.
Okay.
And as now, music director, two of us.
How did that work? Because I remember hearing songs on CCO, like dueling banjos. I would tune in specifically to hear that song. You broke that song.
Yes, he did. In fact, I had seen the movie maybe a day or two prior to I received the 45 from Warner Brothers Pictures, not necessarily the Warner Brothers record label per se. And I thought, wow, this is great. So I called the trade publications right away, put it on, and they said, hey, check this thing out. And it got the station and my first gold record.
You got
it.
Because
I picked it and broke it. Both, which really doesn't happen much anymore.
And it was played quite a bit on CCO.
Oh right? Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Now, how much music was played, though? I mean, I've always thought of WCCO as mostly chat and neighbors talking.
Well, it was all of that, and if, each hour would be different. But I would say maybe at that time, maybe between four and six pieces of music an hour, seven maybe, depending. You remember Franklin Hobbs, the late Franklin Hobbs, you talk about an air shift, he was on from 10:30 p.m. till 5 the next morning. Now, he played music, but that's a long air shift, a long time, especially working all night. But, yeah, I guess it would vary. Certainly, in those day parts, it would be more music for that.
All right. Tell us about some of the brokered shows that you did. Do you have favorites, or were you more knowledgeable about the topic?
Well, I've done a home improvement show probably for like 13 years now, so I have picked up. I haven't quite learned that they say measure twice, cut once. I cut twice, measure once. I still haven't figured that out.
Is that how we do
that? Yeah, but anyway, that's a good show to do. But the shows I like to do that are, I don't like to even call them infomercials, because they do help the listener with things like car repair, computer problems, home improvement, gardening. Now, gardening is the number one leisure time activity in this country, more than any sport combined.
Well, I know one of the shows you do that I worked with
yeah.
On Sundays with was the Wealth Enhancement Show. Bruce Helmer had some nice things to say about it.
Oh, he did.
We started doing the Your Money Show in January of 1997. And the show and CCO absolutely made our business. We would not be the business, or we would not have had the growth we've had without that show. And I got to tell you, personally, in terms of a co-host for the show, you couldn't do better than Denny Long. And here's what I think Denny's real gift is. There's certain radio personalities that are funny or entertaining in and of themselves, but they have to be in the spotlight. Denny's great skill, which I think is an underappreciated skill, is the ability to shine the spotlight on whoever his co-host or guest is. So he shined the spotlight on me and made me look like an expert and made it easy for somebody that had never done radio before to do radio. And I think that's a great gift that he has. You know, he's easy to listen to. He's like a comfortable pair of shoes or a comfortable chair. And the ability to put his ego aside and shine the light on his guest, phenomenal. Couldn't have had a better partner the last 14 years.
These are great. I think talk radio uses and finds much success with these broken shows. It really does two things. It helps the listener, and it brings in revenue. Hey, it's commercial radio.
Yeah.
Hi, Denny Long here for my friends at By the Yard. I know that many of you, want to live greener lives. Well, this is...
Thank you. Thanks, Denny.
All right.
Adrian!